The Philippine Tax Bureau suspends its closure order on property developer Megaworld Corporation. An earlier advisory from the Bureau of Internal Revenue said it was ordering Megaworld to close by May 18th. It did not specify any reason. Megaworld responded by saying it would clarify the matter with tax authorities. The firm later announced the issue had been resolved. It pledged its continued support for the government's revenue programs. Following Megaworld's announcement, the BIR issued an updated advisory saying its closure order was put on hold until further notice. It said Megaworld representatives assured them of their full cooperation with the BIR's requirements. We were told by an insider that BIR simply asked for some documentation and that no BIR audit was actually done, which is usually done before a closure order is even issued. So we're trying to get more details on what really happened yesterday, a back and forth of events right there. But what we do know is that investors, after initially selling down the stock, eventually bought up the stock of Megaworld again. Megaworld shares among the most actively bought up stocks at the end of trade yesterday, up by nearly 3%. Presidential frontrunner Bongbong Marcos has yet to disclose his plans on how to tackle the Philippines' soaring debt. Sovereign debt hit a record 12.7 trillion pesos at the end of March as the administration of President Rodrigo Duterte borrowed heavily to fund the country's COVID-19 response and his ambitious infrastructure program. Marcos's spokesperson, Attorney Vic Rodriguez, points out the present administration is still being led by Mr. Duterte, adding the public should wait for Marcos to assume power to know his plans on how to service the debt. Rodriguez, however, makes it clear that reviving online cockfighting is not an option in raising government revenues.
Not just for Isabong, but for any industry, even if the potential revenue is really, really enticing, if it will compromise the moral fiber of the youth, if it will compromise the value of the Filipino family, President-elect Bongbong is more than willing to let go of that lucrative source.
Cebu Pacific pilot now under disciplinary review over a viral post where he claimed Vice President Lenny Robredo requested priority landing last month. As Jervis Manahan tells us, the airline has also issued an apology for what the office of the Vice President calls a malicious fabrication. Let's watch this.
A high-ranking official of local carrier Cebu Pacific has apologized to Vice President Lenny Robredo and the general public regarding the viral Facebook post of their pilot, Van Ranoa. In his post, Ranoa claimed Robredo used her office to demand priority landing, causing diversions and delaying other flights sometime last month. The pilot slammed Robredo, adding that he had an Australian diplomat and at least 7 infants on board, who were all inconvenienced supposedly by Robredo's demands. Ranoa's post went viral, prompting Cebu Pacific to investigate the allegations. On Tuesday morning, Cebu Pacific's Vice President for Flight Operations Sam Avila confirmed that Ranoa's post had no basis. It was also purely speculative and careless. He took command responsibility and apologized to Robredo and the public. Avila said that while aviators are free to post political opinion, they must do so with prudence. Ranoa is now under disciplinary review. Cebu Pacific says it has strict social media guidelines for their employees. Senate President Tito Soto, for his part, asserts that there are 3 persons in government that are given landing and takeoff priority in all Philippine airports. He was referring to the President, the Vice President, and the Senate President. Ranoa's false claim came after Robredo was lauded for flying economy in the cheapest flight available in her trip to the U.S. to attend the graduation of her youngest daughter. In a statement, the office of the Vice President categorically denies Ranoa's claim, calling it a malicious fabrication. It adds Robredo is committed to take firm steps against disinformation and promote truthful public discourse. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Central Bank opening a currency exchange facility for overseas Filipinos and their families who come back from Ukraine. Through the facility, they can exchange their Ukrainian hryvnia equivalent to not more than 20,000 pesos per eligible person. The exchange may be done in the central bank head office, regional offices and branches, as well as authorized banks. The facility will be available for a limited time only. Now, in March, the Department of Foreign Affairs ordered mandatory repatriation after Russia launched military action to invade Ukraine.